So in the previous episode, we drove to Somerset West. We booked this beautiful, absolutely pretty manor house called Freidenberg Manor House, which I insist everybody should, if you do go to Cape Town, it's a place I insist you'll stay because it's so pretty. But it's also a very convenient location because it's in the middle of all the wineries and all the beautiful wine farms.
Please be careful wherever you walk in the house for the steps.
Yeah.
More.
That's the bars there. The book is lying on the cabinet next to it, so you just help yourself there and just write it in.
Okay.
Alright. And then this is Cape Dutch. So door handle opens up.
Okay.
Alright, let's go.
Thank you. Oh wow, very nice.
Oh wow,
very nice.
That evening, our hosts booked us a beautiful table at a restaurant called Longridge, which also served their own wine. But most importantly, they grew everything in their garden. Nothing was brought from outside. Day 13, we had a delicious breakfast, and then we grabbed the bike and went to Franschhoek. Lunch there. It was delicious. I remember that because it was oysters for me with white wine and babuti for Koos. Pouring there, we walked around beautiful little village, quaint, still has things in colonial and Dutch style housing. And there we saw this very pretty boutique hotel. It was bought up by an Indian businessman, and he converted it into this boutique hotel. And there were some life-size statues in the garden of both Mandela and Mahatma Gandhi. Wineries and well-known houses, windy roads. It was very relaxing.
We left Somerset. It was a heavy heart because it was a very, very nice place. And we followed the coast along the False Bay, they call it. And we then came to Muizenberg Hoek and Fish Hoek in Simontown. No, it was a Monday. It was very, very, it's a holiday there. It was very, very busy on the road and in town as well. And then finally we made our way all the way to Cape Point, Kaap Goede Hoop. After visiting Cape Good Hope, Kaap Goede Hoop, we followed the western coast road, which leads to Cape Town eventually. It's a beautiful road along the coast, and actually we had to pay toll at the end of it, but it was worth every penny.
Harbor House on the waterfront. And we're all back. Okay, say bye.
Bye. They're full of Chinese, and so we decided after.
You cannot say that. Hello. Just say it was.
Since we already.
It was had a good view, and it was very busy.
Since we already seen.
Dad, you cannot say it was full of.
Why are you talking through my thing all the time? Why am I talking then?
Hendrik Lander.
Klomp.
Man.
Hoofdpijn.
You
cannot say Chinese. Just say it was busy.
They were Chinese. I'm not a racist. I saw not much of Chinese.
Just say it was busy.
Okay, I saw a bunch of people who were not Dutch.
What was interesting about the Cape of Good Hope, I learned about why the Dutch got the name, where I learned where the saying comes from, the Flying Dutchman.
Mom, can you speed it up and give some information instead of these stop-start words?
No, I need to prepare this. You have to cut off this section. 60-kilometer dirt road stretch, and you don't have to do that.
Prince Albert Pass.